sobrang ayoko ng budget cut. Sobrang nag-oppose ako doon. Kasi yung budget cut kasi para sa akin, isa siya sa stepping stone na magiging private ng UP, which is hindi dapat.
Marami pang resources na pwedeng pagkunan yung UP na pwede nilang gamitin to compensate for the budget cut.
As a university for the Philippines, it's supposed to be funded by the government. It's the government's responsibility.
Yes, I think that's what they want to say. It's the government's responsibility to fund this government responsibility of educating the people. Our question, should state universities and colleges utilize their assets to augment their budget? Okay, we still have more comments. Miko of Central Luzon State University. Yeah. I just passed there over the weekend. Ang laki-laki ng campus nyo. Malaki nga ang campus namin pero hindi naman developed para maging commercial center. Anong asset ang EU utilize namin? Ang laki-laki ng campus ng Central State University. From Professor Mena of Cavite, pati ba ang sweldo naming mga guro ay maaapektuhan din?
Hindi.
Hindi daw. Hindi po. Tataas from Heidi pa. Of Commonwealth, magiging mabigat sa akin kung tataas ang tuition para makompensate ang paggalaw ng budget dahil ako ay isang ulilang working student.
Okay? Hindi tataas.
Hindi rin.
Guaranteed na ng pasok. No increase will be made.
Sa tuition nila and matriculation.
Yes.
Wala, hindi nyo...
We have initial talks that we will study and as much as possible, we will not increase tuition fees.
Okay.
Yeah, that's also my intention. You know?
Okay, so we're winding up our program today. Give me a sense of what you actually believe in, kung paano dapat i-allocate ng gobyerno ang pondo o ang budget ng education. Paano paghahati-hatian ng basic education at saka ng college. Sa inyo, ano ang pananaw ninyo?
Well, I think
ang share ng CHED?
Well, it should start with the national priorities. Okay. Since we believe the basic education is the bigger
priority
sector.
Oh.
And you need to mold the students at that sector and prepare them for college.
So, agree kayo na doon ibuhos ang mas malaking percentage.
Right now, I think that is a legitimate thing to do because the SUs is also, they can take care of themselves better.
Okay.
Because of what the laws provided them.
Okay.
You know?
But even given the examples na ibinigay sa atin ni Dr. Guevarra na mayroong mga hindi talaga kaya because wala naman silang kakayanan at wala silang assets.
That's where the subsidy comes in.
Kung saan sila pwede.
In.
So yun, isa-subsidize yun. At mayroong pagkukuhanan ang gobyerno ng
Actually,
pondo.
Actually, the bigger institutions should also help there. That's why, you know, nirarationalize yung budget nila. For 2011, PUP, I think, expects an income of more than 200 million.
Mm-hmm.
There is a school in Batangas where the income, the Batangas State University, the income is twice as high as the government subsidy. 200 million lang ang government subsidy, but the income is 450 million.
Anong klaseng eskolahan sila? But
state college.
A state college? SUC. Ilan ang estudyante nila?
I think more than 20,000.
Oho.
Yeah. But the tuition fee is very high.
But they have many students still.
Mataas na yung tuition nila. Marami silang estudyante, malaki ang kinikita nila, at umaasa pa sila na bibigyan sila ng pondo ng gobyerno.
Yes.
Oo. Sa iyo, Dr. Dante, how do you find a solution for these forces contending, the Senate and the state colleges and universities and groups and colleges like yours and universities na kaya naman ninyo, ay yung hindi mga kaya? Paano?
Hindi, I believe yung mga state universities and colleges na hindi nila kaya, dapat subsidize yun.
Ano ang porsyento na subsidy at gano'ng katagal ang subsidy ang aasahan nila?
Until they can generate more income.
Okay, and there are ways to generate income.
Yes, but...
Mainly from the subsidy or they have to build a classroom or they have to build a laboratory or
That's
they have
right,
to build something to be able to attract more people to their school. Saan nila kukunin yun?
From the government muna.
From the government.
Oh.
Okay. Hindi sila pwedeng mag-build, operate ng mga building na pwedeng paupahan at rentahan nila sa mga private developer.
Walang participants eh.
Kasali ba sa devolution ng LGU na pwedeng ibigay sa isang privadong sektor ang pagtatayo ng mga
building sa paaralan na, na public?
BOT, you mean?
BOT.
They can enter into that. Pwede. Joint ventures also.
Joint
if there are participants, of course.
No, no, hindi nga, pero kaya yun.
Yeah.
Sa UP po, what do you see is a solution considering
short
that you're
term,
a finance
we
person?
Might be able to absorb some of the cuts.
Mm-hmm.
But what we're worried about, personally, what I'm worried about is the direction that the government is looking at in the long term, which is towards forcing SUCs to be self-sufficient. As I was saying earlier, if that is the direction, then what's the point in having state-owned colleges and universities? For UP, as the national university, and the law says it is a public institution, that public character has to be retained because it has a special purpose. You know? Students in UP, regardless of their ability to pay, should be considered scholars ng bayan. Dahil they are the ones who will take leadership roles in various disciplines, in various areas in the countries. Of course, together with graduates of other universities. But being scholars ng bayan, their commitment will be much deeper and qualitatively different, you know, because they have this return the commitment to return the support they have gotten through service to the country.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I think points well said. We've listened to the Commission on Higher Education that oversees the state colleges, universities, both public and private.
Yes.
And maybe the areas where they can help insofar as the shortfall in the budget. And Dante here has some proposals as well, but you come on in this program as somebody who's just championing the plight of those who are unable to really find a way to support themselves. Mainly even in day-to-day operations, diba?
That's right.
And then, of course, the newly installed, elected President of the University of the Philippines, Alfred Pascual. Tama ba ako?
Fred Pascual.
Fred Pascual. Okay, thank you so much for your insights and all of you out there. You may be students of the state colleges and universities and parents who have intentions of enrolling their children. This is the state of the present budget deliberations now before the commission, the bicameral, and they're hoping for the best. No, we're all hoping for the best. That's all the time we have. Thank you very much,
thank
gentlemen.
You. Thank you.
Talk to us again next week on Talkback.